Okay, Congresswoman Dr. Tony Lechon calling this personal destruction. How would you call it?
It's not personal destruction, Fermina. You know, the biggest problem, the biggest virus that has inflicted the medical community is infodemic. Infodemic is tantamount to fake news. Ano nangyayari kasi ngayon? What happens now? Anybody can just come out on radio, on TV, get interviewed, and label himself as an expert in certain fields. Kunyari, ganyan, kaliwat kanan, lalabas, public health expert, on the basis of the passage of the Sin Tax Law. Carmina, I was a principal author of the Sin Tax Law. I was a very avid member of the BICOM committee. At marami kami pinagdaanan dyan. Pero hindi namin ginawa yan, na-claim yung credit, because it was a collective effort of many of the legislators. And of course, under the former president, Pinoy Aquino, during that time, was really bent on passing the law. But, you know, if you're an advocate and you would attend Congress hearings, does that not make you a public health expert? And in fact, there was even like claims of Tony Lechon that he's a vaccinology expert because he was invited by former President Rodrigo Duterte in a meeting in Malacanang on vaccination. Again, that does not make you a vaccinology expert. And the problem with that is if that's only internal, then doctors will realize that. But if you come out in the open, you go to TV stations, radio stations, you bring with you the platform of the Department of Health, people can be misled. So let's call a spade. An expert should be equipped with the proper schooling, diploma, certificates, or whatever you would call them, proper training that is conveyed upon by the medical community. Hindi po kasi pwede yan na kanya-kanyang claim na. In fact, this is not just about Tony. No, it's remember, in I have been an advocate in pushing for the Physicians Act in my second term in Congress. And we were doing this because there's a lot of confusion among our patients. Marami naman po kasi talaga ang naniniwala sa ating mga radyo, sa television, and of course in the internet. But it has been abused. Marami ang nagpa-claim ng expert pitch, which is not within the bounds of their expertise. So the patients get confused. So the physician's law has now passed second reading in Congress. It actually aims to streamline the medical profession. So my context with Secretary Herbosa is now if you have the specialty societies, yung ating talaga mga totoong eksperto, and they are not a part of the Department of Health family, and now you have like a consultant who is about to be appointed, who will be heard? And hindi ba magiging masalimuot? Kasi well, in science there will always be dissenting opinion. But the opinion of the majority is what is being carried out. Now, in this case, what will happen? Will it create more fear among our career employees? Kasi ang mangyayari niyan, minsan matatakot na yung mga taong gumalaw. Magiging kawawa rin si Secretary Ted Herbosa kasi mahihirapang gumalaw ang mga totoong eksperto sa loob at labas ng departamento for fear that, again, information will be skewed, it will become malicious, and then they will end up with a lot of cases na wala naman silang kinalaman simply because people are now getting confused who the real experts are.
Congresswoman,
let me
get this question in edgewise. Are you doing this because you have other candidates in mind to be part of the Department of Health? Go ahead.
No, I've been supportive of Secretary Ted Herbosa. He knows that. We have been communicating even before he was appointed. And when he seeks my advice, I would give him some information hanggang sa kaya ko. I don't have any candidate. I'm not recommending anybody. I'm not also recommending any consultant. What I said to Secretary Herbosa when he asked me for help, I told him I am willing to help, but it's a lot better if you get the help of the specialty societies. And let the specialty society recommend. I mean, I'm not in a position to recommend anybody.
Congresswoman, let's put on your previous hat as a former secretary of the health department. How many consultants did you have? And what was your system then for choosing the consultants or advisors, whatever you call them, to be part of your team?
Some of the former secretaries were taken in as consultants. So we have Secretary Cabral, who actually dealt with reproductive health care. Secretary Duque was also in the loop, but he was also civil service chair at that time. Secretary Daidit was also there with regards to his expertise. But the other consultants that were hired were actually based on the recommendation of a search committee that was created within the Department of Health, headed by the time by Secretary Dairit. Mm. So again, I'm not against Tony Lechon as a person, but what I was pointing out is tila nawala yung search committee at yung proseso ng kalusugan ng Department of Health in as in so far as some selection of experts or advisors is concerned. Because when there will be chaos, let's say Carmina in ANC, pagka merong balita, no, you would like to refer to the experts inside your institution. So in the Department of Health, marami pong bureaus at directors yan. And they have their own expertise. They were honed through the years. Now, what will happen if somebody that you take in would have a differing opinion or a dissenting opinion with the career people inside? So magkakaroon ng stalemate. And at the end of the day, the victims, they will be the Filipino people, because no doctor, especially for the several years, no, na maraming doctor who are really hardworking and even are scientists and experts, would be very afraid or would be very cautious if discussions are brought out and then they would there would be misinformation, there would be infodemic, because they know that they hurt the public. So what I am afraid of is the fact that there will be a stalemate if you have advisors who are actually non-experts dealing with the experts within the department, and the specialty society, on the other hand, will not know how to play its position.
All right. So it's very clear from where you're coming from that it's not about the person, it's about the process. Having said that, Congresswoman, how do you think this is going to end? At the end of the discussions between you and Secretary Erbosa, will Dr. Lechon still get to keep his appointment?
To be honest, Carmina, I was also surprised, because what I know is that Dr. Lechon has not been appointed yet. And I believe, with due respect to Secretary Erbosa, syempre medyo nahihiya rin siyang magsabi kasi ayaw naman natin mapahiya si Tony. But what we all know is that he has not been appointed yet. There were talks because he has been applying. And I believe when they had this discussion and when he signed a document, he immediately went out and announced his appointment. But of course, the documents will still have to go through the process. Kasi, to be candid about it, Carmina, we have a lot of people inside the department who are career employees and officials. And the position that Tony Lechon is getting is a director for position. It's equivalent to a director for position in terms of salary, perks, even staff and service vehicles. So, ang problema naman ngayon doon is what will be his accountability. So, medyo yun nga ang katanungan. And then, what will happen to the people inside the department who should actually be managed by that director for position? Mm-hmm. But moving forward, ang tanong ngayon is, has he been appointed or he has yet to be appointed? Because as far as I know, he has not yet been appointed, but he has been going around and claiming to be already a consultant. So, syempre, everybody is keeping silent kasi ayaw mo namang mapahiya siya.
Pero ano ho dapat gawin ni Secretary Erbosa if that situation, as you claim it to be, is real?
Well, he has to bring back and involve the search committee of the department and the human resource department. Because there are a lot of plantilla positions needed. Dr. Tony Lechon can actually work full-time in the department commensurate to his qualifications. Well, he can be with the FDA if he likes. He can be back to PhilHealth because we appointed him there before. Or he can be really a director for and go through the ranks of the Department of Health. So, medyo masalimuot po kasi na you have a director for a position, but you are a consultant. It simply means you have the plantilla position, but you don't have accountability in what you will do. The accountability will go to somebody else.
All right, Congresswoman, sorry, but we ran out of time. Nice to see you again. Thanks for joining us today.
Nice to see you again. Hope to see you again. God bless. Take care, Carmina.
Take care.